Hi Gemini, welcome to your monthly reading for the month of August 2015. So we're gonna get into the cards first, Gemini. The first card that I got for you for this month of August is the Patience card. So Gemini, waiting on something, being patient, being a little bit more nurturing to yourself. This could indicate some of you Geminis could be pregnant or finding out that you're pregnant or entering a new cycle that's gonna take some time. On the second, we have Saturn, Gemini, going direct in your sixth house of health and work. So your daily routine, your daily habits, how have you been managing that? How is it that you can make your life on a day-to-day level and on a work level and on a health level a little bit better? What have you learned to be a little bit more productive with that? We have your ruling planet on the seventh, moving into your fourth house of home. And the relationship you have with your parents, domestic life, you're going to be a little bit more communicative at home towards the 7th of this month. And then on the 8th, Mars, a planet of aggression and energy and a lot of passion, is going to move into your third house of communication. So thinking, communicating with siblings, neighbors, day-to-day traveling. You may be a little bit more aggressive in your communication, a little bit more forceful in your communication in regards to your siblings or your family members, or in terms of your domestic life. So be careful with Mars moving into your third house. It can cause some aggression, Gemini. On the 11th, we have something amazing happening for you, and that's Jupiter, King Luck himself, coming into your fourth house of home and your parents and your past and your roots. You have your ruling planet here, Mercury, already from the 7th, and then we have Jupiter meeting it. So they're going to be together for a little bit here. So your past life, your home life, your upbringing as a child. So it's good for revisioning your future as well, how you could view your relationship with your parents or your life at home or what it is that happened in terms of that. And the second card that I got for you, Gemini, is past lives. So what is it about your past experiences that are now causing some type of fear and anxiety in your present situation? Because there is something there, and Jupiter is here. It's going to be expanding your home, making your home a lot more wonderful to be around. Mercury's there, communication is there. So the fear that you have, just let go of that, Gemini. It's going to pass with Jupiter. It's going to be here until September of next year. So on the 14th, we have a new moon in your third house of communication. So your thinking styles, your learning styles, your siblings, communication with that. There may be a lot of communication by phone. You may be looking differently at your relationships in terms of how it is that you're going to be communicating with the people in your life on a day-to-day level. The sun moves into your fourth along with Jupiter there. And now the sun is here. So a lot of focus in your home life for the month of August, Gemini. A lot of focus in your home life. Attention towards the home. Maybe home may be causing you to go to come back home, or your roots is calling for something, or people in your family need a lot of your attention, or if you're a parent, maybe home life, situations at home will be causing you to be a lot more focused in that sector. Your ruling planet moves into your fifth house on the 27th, around the end of the month. So you're gonna want to be thinking about more happy times, fun times, pleasure, joys, love relationships. You're gonna be wanting to communicate more with your children as well. On the 29th, we have a supercharged full moon happening in your 10th house of career and your reputation, the way you perceive yourself, the way that you look at yourself, Gemini. And the third card that I got for you is the guidance card. So this card to me symbolizes somebody that's going to be looking for guidance in something in regards to their finances as well. This is a good time for promoting yourself. This is a good time for putting yourself to help in terms of your career and how you perceive yourself, Gemini. So this could be, you know, something being offered to you, or you going to talk to someone that probably is more experienced in the field that you do, or that is probably in the level that you would like to be at, trying to ask them certain questions on how it is that they got to this part of their, or this position or this place in their life, Or for those of you that are not concerned with career, this can just be you looking at in terms of your life, what you've accumulated, how do you feel about it? How is it that you can change certain things about what you've accumulated and what differences can happen? This full moon is going to bring a change. It's going to bring an illumination to that sector of your chart. So pay attention to that as well, Gemini. This is also a very good time to just reflect a lot on what it is that you want to do in terms of your 10th house, that career sector, and the way that you feel about yourself in terms of this full moon. And then just let it all bloom. It's really simple. That, excuse me, the wind is talking to me too, I guess, as well as talking to you. But again, Gemini, this is a lot of focus right here on your home life for the month of August. So don't let your past ruin the future at this moment for you, Gemini. Again, I'm Aquila, and I'll see you guys next month.